We're here to show our solidarity to the people of Gaza and the people of Palestine. Scottish Palestine Solidarity Campaign campaigns against Zionism, and it campaigns for the rights and the lives of Palestinian people. We're all angry about the deaths of innocent civilians, women, children and babies in Gaza. Many people have asked what we can do after today, after this demonstration, after this march. What can we do? SPSC, along with Fife Arabic Society, will be hosting a workshop next Saturday in the Old Kirk at 3 o'clock. You can come along and find out more about boycott, divestment, sanctions, things we can do to support Palestine and to oppose Israeli genocide, apartheid, racism. Today it's wonderful you're all here despite the bad weather. We're going to do this march, we're going to film it, we're going to photograph it, we'll put it on Facebook, and our friends in Gaza will know that we've not forgotten them. Our friends in Palestine will know we've not forgotten them. Today we have a lineup of speakers who can each speak for themselves. They'll put their point of view across. Before they do, here's mine, in 2 points. The Palestinian resistance against an illegal occupation is legitimate. It is as legitimate as the resistance by the Jewish fighters in the Warsaw Ghetto in 1943.
Well said. Here, here.
My second point is Israel is a rogue, murderous state which flouts UN resolutions at will. Even the United States of America criticised and condemned it and called its behaviour unacceptable. That's the strongest criticism Israel has ever had from America. And that happened, I think it was yesterday, I was in the car. I nearly crashed my car when I heard it.
Salam everybody. Peace to you and peace to Gaza. And peace to Palestine. Can you hear me? Brothers and sisters, friends, comrades, the statistics are harrowing. So far, 1,800 people have died in Gaza. That's 1 out of 1,000 people. So far, there are 9,000. 9,000 injured. If we compare this to the population of America, that means 1 of 1,000. It comes up to 300,000 people dead in America in 24 days. And it means 1.5 million injured. These figures are unbelievable. And it's all in a strip of land, 27 miles by 9 miles. An open prison has been under siege for 9 years. Gaza is the shame of the world at the present time. Nobody is doing much for Gaza. That's why we're here. We should tell everybody that this is not accepted. Unfortunately, our government still supplies equipment to the Israeli army, some of which is being used against Gaza, and this is totally unacceptable. We have to make sure that Mr. Cameron, as well as the government here and in London, understand that the British people, the Scottish people, will not accept this. It is very important for us to support the people of Gaza for other reasons. They have been, 70% of them are refugees. They've been evicted from their homes 66 years ago. And as refugees, Israel has not allowed them back at all. For the past 9 years they've been under siege. Gaza is still occupied. Israel has a duty to the occupied population. Instead of looking after their welfare, it's bombing them, it's killing them, it's injuring them, it's blowing up their homes, it's making their life impossible. There is genocide going on, there are war crimes going on, and we say not in our name. Enough is enough. Brothers and sisters, friends, comrades, let us make sure it is a starting point for us here in Fife, and that further steps will follow to make sure that we support justice in Palestine, we support the right of Palestinian people to self-determination, and we support Gaza's call to live like normal human beings. Long live Palestine! Yeah. Long live Gaza!
Today we are here in solidarity with the people of Gaza, and will it be raining here? We are proud to be here and send out our support and our solidarity to people in Gaza and across Palestine, and to send out a message that we are outraged at the actions of the Israeli government. Today is not about party politics, and it's not about whether we're voting or not in the referendum. Today is about us standing together, united in our condemnation of Israel's actions in Gaza and across Palestine, united in our goal of securing the return of land to the Palestinian people and of ending Israel's reign of oppression, terror and genocide. This week, as Bill has pointed out, we've even seen America, one of Israel's strongest backers, publicly denounce the atrocities committed by Israeli soldiers. We stand shoulder to shoulder with the people of Gaza, and we send a message out from here today from our communities up and down Fife that we will not tolerate Israel's blatant abuse of human rights, breach of international law, or its shameful killing of innocent children. Well, here in Fife, we've been enjoying spending time with our families over the summer before the weather changed. For families in Gaza, the past few weeks have seen an already desperate existence get even worse. Many families have been literally torn apart or wiped out entirely. Over 500,000 have been displaced from their homes. But these atrocities aren't something new. They can't be seen in isolation, even if the BBC would like us to see that, get that impression. This is a siege that's been going on for years. It's 7 years since Israel imposed a blockade on Gaza because Palestinians elected a government Israel did not approve of. And it's 7 years since 1.75 million Palestinians in Gaza have been collectively punished. 50% of the population are children, not old enough to vote, yet every single day collectively punished by the Israeli government. Children who should have everything to look forward to, denied the basic essentials of life, the right to medicine, the right to food, the right to clean water, and cut off from the outside world, punished simply for being a Palestinian, denied the basic human rights every single child has under international law. And just when people of Gaza thought things couldn't get any worse, they're now trapped on all sides with no way of escaping the Israeli bombardment. Already 1,800 Palestinians have died. At least 1 in 4 of them are children. Children who thought they were safe when they sheltered in a UN school, whose lives were tragically cut short when they were killed in their sleep by Israeli missiles. 17 times the UN warned the Israeli army that this was a UN shelter, yet still the Israeli government carried on their shameful act of terror. Children who were playing football on the beach, shot by Israeli gunships. Children playing on swings in their local play park, celebrating Eid, killed by Israeli gunfire. And Israel's response in the face of condemnation from across the world, even from the United States, well, they say they're going to call up even more ground troops and intensify their illegal war. Well, enough is enough. Now is the time to act. No country should be above the law. It's simply not acceptable for the international community to turn a blind eye to the atrocities that are happening every single minute of every day in Gaza and across Palestine. To turn a blind eye when the lives of Palestinian children are being undermined and destroyed by this brutal Israeli government. To turn a blind eye when family homes are bulldozed to make way for Israeli settlers. To turn a blind eye when families are faced with a blockade that cuts them off from the world and denies them access to basic essentials of life, such as water. To turn a blind eye when children in UN hospitals and shelters are blown up by a government which not only denies people their freedom, but denies them the right to life and denies children the right to a childhood. It's time for our governments at Scottish, UK and European level to put sanctions on Israel and ensure that those responsible for Israel's war crimes and continued violations of human rights are held to account. And it's time for each one of us to use our power as consumers to boycott Israeli goods and tell those companies that continue to invest in Israel that we won't be shopping with them anymore. Just as we did in the 1980s to end apartheid in South Africa, we will send out a message of support and solidarity to the Palestinian people and a message to the Israeli government that they may ignore resolutions, UN resolutions. We are not prepared to sit back and watch the bloodshed unfold on our TV screens and allow Israel to operate what is an apartheid regime? How many children need to die before we take action? How many more Palestinians need to be driven from their homes, forced to live in refugee camps to make way for Israeli settlers? Scotland has got a proud tradition of international solidarity, and here in Kirkcaldy and across Fife, we send our support and solidarity to Gaza. We call not just for a ceasefire, but for justice for the Palestinian people. We call for an end to the illegal occupation of Palestinian land and the right of Palestinians to return to their homes. We call on our UK government to demand an immediate end to the Israeli state murder in Gaza and to impose sanctions and an arms embargo on Israel until they comply with international law. You'll be pleased to hear I'm almost finished. And we call for those who have committed acts of terror, such as the bombing of schools and hospitals and the killing of innocent children, to be held accountable for the war crimes that they have committed. Across Scotland and across the UK, thousands are speaking out for Gaza. We will continue to stand up for justice, to stand up for human rights, to stand up for peace, and to stand up for the people of Palestine. Thank you.
Today on a crappy day shows that you're disgusted and saddened and horrified by the mass murder of Palestinian civilians. It's the majority of people killed last night were Wayans, were absolutely defenseless. And I ask you this, think what image comes to your mind when a soldier is captured or killed and the occupying army slaughters scores and scores of civilians. What's the comparison that jumps into your mind? It's of a time and a place that we would rather forget. And everybody knows, you don't need to talk about the name. You know what I'm talking about. It's genocide. Israel is deliberately killing civilians because they are the wrong kind of people. They are to be removed and they are to be replaced by Jewish immigrants from around the world. That's the plan. And Obama, and this is openly discussed in Israel, openly. Imagine the university near here held a conference on the demographic threat to Scotland by too many black people or too many Muslims. You would think the BNP had come to power. This is openly discussed in university conferences in Israel. The demographic threat. Too many of the wrong kind of people. It is a monstrous, racist society predicated upon the removal of the native people and their replacement by immigrants from around the world. And our government arms them, supports them, protects them, and isolates the Palestinians at every opportunity, even from membership of the United Nations. And how disgusting to watch Obama on the telly yesterday live. When Palestinian resistance fighters capture one Israeli soldier from the invading army, he says this is barbaric. It is not barbaric, it's a duty to defend your homes and your family against invaders. And he says Israel's slaughter of 1,600 people is their right to defend themselves. They have no right to defend themselves. Britain has no right to defend itself in Iraq. It's not defence, it's aggression. We have no right to defend ourselves in Afghanistan or anywhere else. It's aggression. And the Israelis have no right to attack the survivors of the native people they drove into Gaza and who are trying to dig tunnels back to their own homes, the villages they were driven out of, and of which they are the rightful owners. Friends, the Israelis make money from war. When when they test their vicious weapons on the bodies of Palestinians, they have a commercial edge on the grisly international arms market. The people from around the world, the dictatorships and the democracies who buy their weapon systems, pay an extra percentage because they were tested on the living bodies of the people of Gaza. That's the grisly reality. We are not watching a defensive war, we're watching a commercial operation as much as anything else. John Kerry went to Palestine and Israel last week, and they opened up their weapons stores to replenish the Israeli murder machine. And he offered $47 million in medical aid to the people of Palestine, the injured and violated and murdered people of Palestine. Kerry went and he said, I have $47 million in medical aid. It's disgusting. It's the rapist walking home after the crime and consoling the victim. Guns and weapons and white phosphorus for the Israelis, and bandages and weapon and hospital support for the victims. And the Scottish Government is no better. They're offering medical aid and they're supporting Israel's attack on Gaza, which is disproportionate. Disproportionate means you have a right to attack but kill fewer people. But the Palestinians must cease immediately their rockets. This, friends, is not acceptable. The Palestinians have a right to defend themselves, a duty to defend themselves, and we have a duty to support them. Yeah. I'll finish with this. This is one massacre that's making people sick, fed up with this horrible, violent, ethnic cleansing settler state. The cycle is usual. They massacre, we march, they stop, they resume their normal rate of killing, and we go back to normal. Friends, please don't do it. Please don't do it. We have to organise now to prevent the next massacre, to take on Israel and Scotland, to take on the Raytheon company in Glenrothes, which supplies them with weapons, to take on the various supports of Zionism here. Friends, please, don't go back to normal after this particular appalling act of genocide. Join the Scottish Palestine Solidarity Campaign. Punish Israel for the crimes. Make sure that they won't, with impunity, embark upon another massacre. And they always ache to complete the ethnic cleansing of Palestine. We must not allow them. Marvellous you've come out in the rain. But please, for the years to come, keep focus on the heroic, indomitable people of Gaza. The people who refuse to give up. They are a model and an example to all of us. And I say this, if I was in Gaza, I would oppose Hamas. I don't agree with their social policy, but I say this, thank you for resisting. Thank you for winning elections. Thank you for showing the world that you will not be defeated. Thank you very much, everybody.
Attention being given to the assault on children, civilians, and elderly men and women, like our own children, like mine and yours, like your parents and mine, like your elderly people and our elderly people, absolutely helpless. In the 1990s, Rabin wished and made it very clear that he would like Gaza to disappear from the face of the earth. He wished that it go and drop in the sea. Well, there is a Gaza in every one of us. There is Palestine in our blood, in our thoughts, in everything we breathe. The past few weeks, the people in Gaza, as you all know, they've been living on earth, a hell on earth. They are surrounded from the sea, from the ground, and from the air. It reminds me of the stories that we heard about the concentration camps. Except the concentration camps weren't bombed day and night. The children are starving. The women are widowed. The mothers are lost their loved ones. The U.S. gives us lip service while they are saying that they don't agree with it and they oppose it, but they release their weapons that is stored in Israel to the worth of £1 billion of bombs, of shells, of artilleries. And what is more, the supplies, as Mick said earlier on, of medicine to Israel. Israel, the only country in the Middle East that has nuclear weapons. If the assault that is happening now is done by any other country, Britain and America would bomb that country the way they did with Iraq, the way they did with Afghanistan, and they're doing so.
Yes!
Today, we shouldn't stop. This is the beginning of our support to Gaza and to Palestine. We should demand that everyone in the Israeli cabinet be indicted and condemned as a war criminal.
Yes!
Every head of state, every company, every supplier, every traitor that supports Israel one way or another should be indicted and condemned as a war criminal.
Yes!
We must end the apartheid. We must stop the genocide. We must stop the ethnic cleansing. Thank you for coming. I pray for you and for everybody. Thank you for listening.
Now, if I, and that message is, we do not believe that it is acceptable that bombs, bullets and weapons rain down on innocent men, children, innocent women in Gaza, and that humanity says it is not acceptable. Across the world, governments should be speaking out. If it was any place else other than happening with Israel and Gaza, then governments would be talking about sanctions. Governments would be talking about taking direct action against a state who persecute, who bomb, who fire missiles, and who murder innocent children. So that's the message that comes to Fife today. And you know, there is a crowd here today, and I'm delighted to see this crowd. But I believe in every community, in every street, in Fife, in Scotland, across the UK, across Europe, there are people who are saying it is not acceptable to murder innocent men, innocent women, and innocent children. Yeah. And the signs, and what we have seen on our TVs, what we have seen is not acceptable. So that's the message today. Movements start from small beginnings. I believe people are absolutely outraged at what we're seeing, and therefore we can build a movement across Scotland, across Fife, across Scotland, across the UK, a movement right across the world that says stop the murdering, stop the killing, lift the sanctions that are there, lift the prison imprisonment of the people of Gaza and the Gaza Strip, and let's look for action. So thank you for this morning. This is the start. Thank you.
Speaking to you today as a member of Scottish Jews for Just Peace and also of Jews for Palestinians' Rights and Return. I would much rather that these and the many similar organisations didn't need to exist. But so long as the Israeli state continues to propagate racism, anti-racist Jews will need to bear witness to the fact that the Israeli state does not represent all Jews. And crucially, the criticism of Israel and of Zionism is not anti-Semitic. So we need to do our small bit to expose the Israeli propaganda machine, which attempts to tie all Jews to the Zionist project and tries to shut down all criticism with strident cries that criticism of Israel amounts to anti-Semitism. I know that the people I meet on these demos know better than that. But when any of you are talking to people who've not looked beyond the propaganda, I think it can help to be able to quote Jewish organisations that don't accept the Israeli version of events. My parents' generation, the generation that lived through the Holocaust, saw Jewish refugees denied sanctuary by countries such as the US and Britain. They genuinely believed that a Jewish state was necessary as a sanctuary for the Jewish people. They believed this would free Jews from anti-Semitism. What a false promise that was. In attempting to tie Jews to an increasingly aggressive colonial project, Israel has propagated the lie that all Jews are responsible for Israel's actions, and so fueled a new anti-Semitism. Far from making Jews safer, Israel has created a situation where it's normal for synagogues all over the world to have security protection, and where anti-Jewish talk is no longer restricted to the far right. Israel's actions have become more and more brazenly brutal. And modern media has allowed us to see both the devastating images from Gaza and the open displays of Jewish supremacism on Israel's streets and even in the Israeli parliament. A natural outrage at what is happening has spread to people who never before bothered much with Middle East politics. But our news media is very bad at putting current events in historical context. It's not just about what triggered the present assault or even the long strangulation of the siege of Gaza. The roots of today's tragedy lie firmly in the basic concept of a Jewish state, that is, of a state based on ethnicity. Early Jewish settlers may have had idealistic dreams of shared kibbutz life, but these dreams excluded the existing Palestinian population. The concept of the ethnic-based state is a cancer at the heart of Israel, and it's had a devastating psychological impact on the very people it was set up to protect. Jews are not intrinsically better or worse than any other people. But as history has shown many times over, colonialism and ethnic superiority will produce a brutal and brutalized society. Strong, relentless criticism of Israel is the best hope for all the people of Israel-Palestine, both Palestinian and Jew. When the Israeli government talks about the threat to Israel's existence, it isn't referring to a physical threat to the life of its people. What it's concerned about is Israel's continued existence as a specifically Jewish state. It is this that underlies the historic and continuing expulsion of the Palestinians from their homes and land, and the perpetual harassment and second-class treatment of those who insist on remaining. It is also behind Israel's shocking treatment of asylum seekers from Africa. Ultimately, there will be no lasting peace until there's been a change in the nature of the Israeli state, so that it gives the same rights to all of its people, including the right of return for Palestinian refugees. And it stops turning its people into bullies. Only then will the people of Palestine, both Jews and Palestinians, truly be free from the river to the sea. Free, free Palestine!
Free Palestine!
Stop the slaughter. Stop the grotesque inhumanity displayed by the State of Israel, which now stands clearly as a terrorist state, a rogue nation, and a war criminal worthy of isolation and boycott. In the name of humanity and basic human rights, the world must boycott Israel and cast them into the wilderness as the apartheid South Africa of the 21st century. Collectively, the world helped to bring racist South Africa to its knees, and we broke that apartheid state. So now, the world has to bring the Israel terror state to its knees. We must prevent the ongoing genocide against the people of Palestine. If the rule of law means one thing in the 21st century, then Israel must be boycotted. Israel must be isolated. Israel must be disarmed. We must stand now and say that we are all Palestinians. In our hundreds and our millions, we are all Palestinians. In our hundreds and our millions, we are all Palestinians. In our hundreds and our millions, we are all Palestinians.
Friends and comrades, thank you very much indeed for coming out today. If it is anything, it shows that we do care as human beings, as people who have families. What is happening in Gaza is a shame upon the whole world. Shame on you, Obama. Shame on you, Cameron. Shame on you, Netanyahu. We don't want any more crimes to be committed in Gaza. We don't want any more genocide in Gaza. This must stop. The occupation must stop. The whole of Gaza is full of young children who cannot find food, they cannot find milk, they cannot find water, their electricity is non-existent, they don't have any fuel. This is not acceptable. You shouldn't accept this for your own family, you shouldn't accept it for the people of Palestine. Brothers and sisters, friends and comrades, this is our first step here in Fife to make sure we continue our support for the Palestinians. Do please join the Scottish Friends of Palestine. There are forms everywhere. Do please make a wee donation. Do please come to our meeting next week at Old Kirk, 3 o'clock. It's to discuss BDS, it's to discuss where to go next. For now, thank you very much indeed. Free, free Palestine! Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Palestine, Palestine!
Gaza, Gaza, don't you cry!
Palestine.
Gaza, Gaza, don't you cry!
We will never let you die!
Gaza, Gaza, don't you cry!
We will